Hello friends, myself Bharat from CP Corp. Today we are going to tell you about fluid mechanics, how to prepare them. These are the topics which we are going to cover in our entire video lecture. First one is fluid properties, second pressure measurement, third hydrostatics, fourth buoyancy, fifth fluid kinematics, sixth fluid dynamics, seventh flow through pipes, eighth viscous flow in pipes, 9th turbulent flow, 10th boundary layer, 11th flow over submerged bodies, and final dimension analysis. Now for the gate point of view, fluid properties, pressure measurement, hydrostats, buoyancy, fluid kinematics, fluid dynamics, yes, of course, flow through pipes, not so important. Viscous, important. Boundary layer, not so important, just one or two questions from there. Turbulent, not important. Flow over submerged bodies, dimension analysis, not important. And this is also important. So for the gate point of view, these are the important topics for gate. And for ES point of view, dimension analysis is very, very important. Flow over submerged bodies, very important. Turbulent, very important, which is not important for gate. So we have to cover all the topics for ES, and for gate we have to be subjective. So now we are going to start with fluid properties. Fluid mechanics is not a very tough subject as you people think. It's a very easy subject, but at it is called fluid mechanics, that is fluid plus mechanics. So mechanics, we all know that we have not a very good command over it. Now fluid properties. Fluid properties. What are the properties that we are going to see? Now, first of all, we would like to tell you what is fluid. Suppose take an element and it is on a surface. If we applied a force Fs on the surface of this fluid, what is this going to do? It will deform. See, it will deform. When a force Fs is applied, this will deform like this. Phi. That is deformation in time dt. So this is a fluid. Fluid is a substance which deforms under a force when acted or upon a surface of that fluid. Now what is this called? As you all know, that is modulus of rigidity. G is equal to stress, that is shear stress, on strain, that we have strain, and G modulus of rigidity. G is equal to tau by phi, that is shear stress upon strain. Now, the next most important thing in fluid properties is viscosity. What is viscosity? Viscosity is, suppose when a liquid is undergoing some flow, and these are suppose the layer 1, layer 2. So when a fluid is moving this direction, what happens between the two layers? These two layers try to oppose each other. Means if a layer is moving in this direction, then it will oppose the motion of the opposite or the next layer opposite to it. Take another layer moving in this direction. This will try to bring it to the rest. Okay, this is the viscosity. Now this property of resting these surfaces by this surface is terms as viscosity. I'm going to denote it by mu. Viscosity. The next very important property is density. Or it is also known as mass density. Mass density or specific mass. Density is equal to mass upon volume. Remember, it is called density, mass density, or specific mass. Wherever the word specific comes before any term, now that quantity or that term will be divided by volume. As you can see, specific mass, so mass is divided by volume. So remember this, don't confuse it. Mass unit, kg. Volume meter cube, kg per meter cube. Now density of water, there are some values which you have to remember. Density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. Remember this value. 1000 per meter cube. Kg per meter cube, sorry. Now the general value density of air can be taken as 1.2 kg per meter cube. Now in ES, you have to take the value. If it is not given, then you have to take the value as density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube and density of air as 1.2 kg per meter cube. Not density. Okay. Then the next fluid property that we are going to undertake is weight density. Weight density or specific weight. Now, before the word weight, there is a specific, so obviously the weight will be divided by volume, and it is denoted by, I'm going to denote it by omega. Specific weight upon volume. Weight is equal to mg volume v. Now look here, m by v, which constitute density, mass upon volume, mg. So specific weight can also be written as rho g. Look, these are the important concepts that must we tell you people, so that you may not confuse and use again and again in fluid mechanics. So weight density of water, density of water into g, density of water 1000 into 9.81 9810. Now what will be its unit? Weight upon volume. Weight, Newton, volume, meter cube. Newton per meter cube. Remember this formula. So the next fluid property that we are going to see is very, very important. Mark it down, very, very important. It is specific gravity or relative density. Relative word, it's basically denotes a ratio So relative density RD or S. Relative density, what it is? It is specific weight of any fluid divided by specific weight, the standard fluid. This is the general definition of relative density of or specific gravity. Now, as I already told you, specific weight of any fluid means specific weight. Specific weight can also be written as rho of fluid, any fluid, g, rho g upon rho of standard fluid into g. G, g cancel out, rho f upon rho standard fluid. So specific gravity can also be written as ratio of density of fluid to the density of standard fluid. Now here comes a term, standard fluid. What is standard fluid? Standard fluid in case of liquid, it is taken as water, and in case of gases, it is taken as air. So this is the importance of the value that I have previously given you, so that it can be used here. Density of water and density of air. It is very important, remember this. There are so many questions asked in GATE as well as in ES directly from this. Now, I'm going to tell you more about some density of different fluids. Gasoline, like gasoline, it is asked in ES. Gasoline specific gravity is equal to 0.75. Now, its specific gravity is 0.75. What it means? Look, when specific gravity is less than 1, and when specific gravity is greater than 1. Specific gravity less than 1 means, now you will get to know the importance of a specific gravity. Actually, by seeing the value of specific gravity, you can tell it is heavier or it is lighter. So when it is less than 1, what we are going to do, we are compare it with the standard fluid, which in case gasoline liquid, which is in water. I'm going to compare it with water. So specific gravity less than 1 means it is lighter than water, and specific gravity greater than 1, like in mercury, it is 13.6, greater than 1, it is heavier than water. Now finally, a last fluid property of utmost importance is compressibility. Yeah. As you all know, that bulk modulus is equal to change in pressure upon change in volume to the original volume with a negative sign. Why negative sign? Look, suppose there is a gas inside the cylinder. When you apply a force of, say, pressure, the volume goes on decreasing. Volume goes on decreasing with increasing the pressure. The more you apply the pressure, the more the volume will be settled down or less, so that it's inversely proportional. So remember, whenever the pressure will increase, the volume will decrease. So the keeping this quantity to be positive, it is supplied here as negative. Now what is compressibility? Compressibility is nothing but it is inverse of bulk modulus, compressibility. Now there are some more topics to be covered, but this video is getting too long, so we'll cover it in next video. Okay, thanks for watching, and please subscribe if you want to see more lectures. Thank you.